My name is Dr. Alim Mitha, and I'm an associate professor of clinical neurosciences and a cerebrovascular and endovascular neurosurgeon at the Foothills Hospital in Calgary, Alberta, Canada. Calgary has a population of about 1.4 million people. When you include the total catchment area, it's about 2 million people. If you consider aneurysms rupturing at a rate of about 10 to 15 per 100,000 people per year, that means we treat aneurysms, ruptured aneurysms, every few days. So in total, we treat about 150 aneurysms a year. Aneurysms are caused when small blood vessels in the brain break down and cause an area of weakness. This weakness develops into a balloon, and when this balloon ruptures, it causes a stroke, leading to death in up to 1 in 7 patients. I treat aneurysms the conventional open surgical way, where we do a craniotomy and clip the aneurysm, as well as the endovascular way. The endovascular field is heavily device-based and rapidly changing. Some of the devices that I personally use include coils, stents, flow diverters, as well as intrasaccular devices such as the web. Using angiography, which is a type of X-ray, a small tube or catheter is navigated from the wrist or the leg up into the small blood vessels of the brain. Once the catheter reaches the right location, a stent is placed across the opening of the aneurysm to divert blood flow. This type of stent is a small metal mesh tube that redirects blood flow away from the aneurysm in order to reduce the risk of stroke. However, in 20 to 40% of patients at 1 year after treatment, the blood flow is not diverted properly, and patients may need to be treated again. Some of the novel treatments we are exploring include the use of absorbable devices, as well as stem cells to improve the healing of brain aneurysms.
Hi, I'm Brooke, the PhD candidate working with Dr. Mitha on this project. My job is to figure out exactly how these stem cells can improve aneurysm healing. Stem cells are a unique type of cell found all over the adult body, found in your bone marrow, your fat, and your blood, among other places. These cells go to areas of inflammation, turn into the damaged tissue, and help secrete proteins that improve healing and make the body heal quicker. I isolate primary stem cells from fat tissue and grow them in culture in the lab. Once we have enough stem cells, we can freeze them to use at a later date. Our lab has shown that stem cells can help improve aneurysm healing and permanently close the opening to the aneurysm. Although we know they can help, we need to learn a lot more about how they're doing so before we can move into clinical trials.
With the help of the Brain Aneurysm Foundation, we have been able to explore the use of stem cells and their impact on aneurysms.
The potential impact of this project is exciting because we know it can improve the lives of so many patients if moved into clinical trials. I've had a long-standing involvement with the Brain Aneurysm Foundation. I was first introduced to them while doing research at the Massachusetts General Hospital in 2005. We have also benefited from the support that the Brain Aneurysm Foundation provides for patients, including literature, as well as the trinkets that make our patients feel like they're part of something bigger. So the Brain Aneurysm Foundation has really impacted me in a positive way, both in my academic focus and in the care that I can provide for my patients. We've also started a local Brain Aneurysm Foundation support group chapter that really allows our patients to meet face-to-face and share their experience with either a ruptured or an unruptured brain aneurysm. So I wanted to say thank you to the Brain Aneurysm Foundation for everything they've done for me, our community, as well as all of our patients.